Hello, we have here a ladder leaning against a smooth wall, and we are going to solve for all the other forces acting on this ladder. Since the floor is rough, we will have both the normal component and the frictional component. The ladder has a tendency to slide rightward, and that's why we know the frictional force must be acting leftward. This is a smooth wall, so we have only the normal component and no frictional component. The first thing we're going to do is to take moments about point X, which is this point here. So when we consider moments about this point, N1 and F1 will not come into the picture because they act right at that point, so they have no turning effect about this point here. So all we have is the clockwise moment exerted by N2, which must be balanced by the anti-clockwise moment exerted by the weight of the ladder. So we have N2 times the perpendicular distance of 4 meters. See, a horizontal force must have a vertical perpendicular distance, and this must be balanced by 10 newtons times the perpendicular distance of 1.5 meters. So from here we solved, N2 is actually 3.75 newtons. So I hope that you realize that when we take moments about point X, it's not as if we expect the ladder to be rotating about point X. It's just that since the ladder is at rest, we know that we can evaluate moments about any point we want and still expect all the clockwise moments to be balanced by all the anti-clockwise moments. So for this problem, we choose to evaluate moments about point X because, you see, it allows me to keep N1 and F1 out of the equation, and that allows me to solve N2 immediately. Next, we know that horizontally, all the leftward forces must be balanced by all the rightward forces. So in this problem, horizontally we have only F1 and N2. So the leftward F1 must be balanced by the rightward N2. So F1 turns out to be 3.75 newtons as well. Of course, vertically, all the upward forces must be balanced by all the downward forces. So we have the upward N1, which must be balanced by the downward weight, which is 10 newtons. So N1 is 10 newtons. Very often you'll be asked to compute the contact force, which is basically the resultant of the normal contact force and the frictional force. To find the magnitude of the contact force, we just do a Pythagoras of the vertical and horizontal components. To solve for the direction of the contact force, we'll do the tangent ratio. So the contact force turns out to be at an angle of 69.4 degrees above the horizontal. By the way, since the ladder is experiencing just three forces, N2, the weight, and the contact force, actually we know that these three forces, their lines of action should intersect at the same point. So 69.4 degrees looks about right. So basically, to solve a static equilibrium problem involves you forming equations. And you can form equations out of the fact that vertically the forces must sum up to zero, or horizontally the forces must sum up to be zero, or rotationally the moments evaluated about any point should also be zero. So have fun choosing your pivot points and forming all those equations. Okay, that's all. Ta-ta.